And it was a pleasure present you the first our reporter, Irina Stashova. The title is A Priori Estimates of Minimizer in a Control Parabolic Problem. Due to custom, since she is not here but online, but I hope it doesn't influence on understanding and discussion.
Okay, thank you for my introduction, Alexei. I would like to thank at first the organizers of this conference. This conference and the participation in this conference is very important for us, for me and for my co-authors and colleagues, Alexey Filinovsky and Dmitry Lashin, because as we will see, we use Ladyzhinsky spaces during all our paper, and I will say a few words about this mathematical model, which we will speak about. Okay, so here you can see our group. We worked on this problem during 13, I think, years. And we started from the agricultural model. And now, of course, we are far from this origin, and we continue with mathematics. We study the problem of control over temperature condition in industrial greenhouses. For a model based on a one-dimensional parabolic equation on a bounded interval with quadratic cost functional, we prove the existence and uniqueness of a control function from a prescribed set and study the structure of the set of acceptable temperature functions. We also prove the positivity principle to the parabolic boundary value problem and obtain the inequality for positive solution. Also, we prove some technological inequality, and some of them are non-standard inequalities for the control functions. Here you can see the outline of my report. I will say a few words about agricultural background. After that, we pose the mathematical model based on the parabolic equation. We formulate the positivity principle. We obtain the inequality for solutions, pose the extremum problem. After that, I will show you some necessary condition to minimizer and inequalities for the control function. And after that, we'll discuss some qualitative properties of minimizer. So let's start. Here you can see the cell house as a long parallelepiped. Here you can see the tubes with the hot water. It is a heat of this greenhouse. Here you can see the windows at the sail. So this condition we will see in our mathematical model. You can see here the Rolls line and the cucumber line and the salad line, and for any model, for every this model, we use the same model, mathematical model to describe how can we heat our greenhouse. So when growing plants in industrial hothouses, some temperature conditions are needed at some fixed height corresponding to the growth point of the plants. The growth point, it is the point where leaves, fruits, sprouts are formed. These conditions should be maintained according to the circadian schedule with a small deviation admitted. One can make the temperature to rise by heating the floor of the hothouse and to fall by opening ventilator windows at the sail. a hot house can be treated as an elongated parallelepiped. And we can see its cross sections that are perpendicular to its longest side. Now we can propose the mathematical model, and you can see some picture which illustrates our description. Here you can see the height of our greenhouse. This is the long parallelepiped. This is its cross section. And here you can see the height from zero to unit. This is the growth point x0. Here you can see the target function z of t. And here you can see the solution of our problem. And we can obtain some closure in some integral sense of our solution to this target given function z of t. By the way, a lot of works consider it so-called terminal observation or final observation. And in our work, we consider so-called pointwise observation. So we have together the temperature close to the given function during the whole period zero t capital. Okay, let's start with the mathematical model. Consider the mixed problem for this heat equation of the general type. Here you can see different terms of this equation with boundary conditions. Phi of t, it's our control function, will be in future. And here you can see the second boundary condition, psi of t. It gives us by the ventilator of windows. And here you can see the initial condition, psi of x as x lies at the segment zero unit. And we suppose that this function is smooth in our rectangle, and this condition fulfills. We will consider our functions phi, psi, and xi from these spaces, and w to one. Is Sobolev space of weakly differentiable functions with this common norm. And we suppose that phi, psi and xi to be given functions and phi to be a required control function. So we will discuss the function phi and its properties. By v2 one zero at this rectangle, we denote the Banach space of all functions from this space with the finite norm, which will improve by will include was included by Ladyzhinskaya and later in the book written by Ladyzhinskaya, Salonikov, Uraltseva, and we denote by W tilde to one the space of all function eta of x and t from the space satisfying these conditions. Here we introduce the definition of solution to this problem. We call function u from this space the energy class weak solution for our problem. It's is in the book written by Ladyzhinskaya, Salonikov, Uraltseva. If this condition holds and for any function eta from this space, the integral identity holds. Under these conditions, any weak solution from W210 automatically belongs to this space. The proof of this fact you can find in Ladyzhinskaya book here. At first, we can prove this lemma that there exists a unique weak solution to our problem belonging to our space. It satisfies the following inequality with the constant C1 independent of phi psi and xi. And as a corollary, we can obtain the continuous dependence of this solution from the initial datum and boundary datum. Now, let me formulate the positivity principle. It's so called the maximal principle, maybe some kind of maximal principle, but we will call it positivity principle and to use this principle for obtaining some estimations of the function u. Let u be a solution of this problem with the boundary and initial conditions, phi psi and xi, satisfying these inequalities. Then our solution is also non-negative and satisfies this inequality too. The next theorem illustrated the estimates of our solutions at the point x zero under these conditions. You can see it at the slide here. If this condition holds, then for solution u of our problem, this inequality holds. This inequality holds. Here you can see the estimates of the coefficient a and the norm of initial and boundary functions. And as a corollary, we will obtain the same fact as psi and xi equal zero. Then we obtain the exact estimates with the help of this function phi. This is the control function. Let me pose now the extreme problem. Let me denote by phi the set of control functions phi small and by z capital the set of objective functions z. We will suppose that phi is non-empty, closed, convex, and bounded set, and consider the weight integral post-functional of this type. Here you can see that u phi is the solution of our previous boundary value problem with the given control function phi. So we use here this index phi as the notion. Rho is a real valued weight function bounded from below and from above by positive constants. Assuming now that the function z and rho to be fixed, consider the minimization problem, this minimization problem, and we can constate that for any z of this space, there exists a unique function phi zero such that this equality holds. The next theorem gives us the necessary condition, one necessary condition to minimize it. Let phi zero be a minimizer, then for any phi of this space, the following inequality holds. This is some analog of Lyon's necessary condition, but for our problem. Now we can obtain the instandard, non-standard inequalities estimated the control function by this functional. Let x zero and this function satisfies the previous conditions, the previous conditions of the previous theorem, then the following inequality holds. And we obtained in the space L1 the estimates of this norm from below with, by the way, the meaning of this functional and the estimates of the function rho, it's a weight function in our functional and of the coefficient A in our equation. And by the way, with the point x zero. And as a corollary, we will obtain the same estimate when these functions equal zero. You can see it here. It's more simple to understand. We obtained the same inequality in this space for this function psi phi. Now I'll say a few words about qualitative properties of minimizer. It's very interesting that if our coefficients does not depend on t, and this meaning is positive, then the phi zero belongs to the boundary of the set phi. Of the set phi, it is the first very important qualitative property of minimizer, and the second one will be as follows: let our coefficients doesn't depend on t, and we have two sets of control functions. These sets are bounded, convex and closed in the space W to one, such that one of this space lies inside of another space. If this meaning is positive, then we have this inequality. Of course, if we write here less than or equal to, it's evident inequality, but we obtain this strong inequality here. What can we say about other properties? We call the problem exactly controllable from the set phi to the set z if for any z of the space there exists phi zero such that this functional equals zero. The exact control is the function phi zero, making the functional to vanish in this sense. If we will consider the exact controllability, we can formulate this very interesting theorem. The set Z of all functions admitting exact control I such that this functional equals zero for some function phi is the first bare category subset in L2. So it's very thin set. But if we introduce the definition of densely controllability, then we obtain the more fruitful result. We call the problem densely controllable from the set phi to the set z if for any z from the space we have that this meaning m small, not the functional, but this minimum of this functional equals zero. Now we will formulate to minimize C. Let the coefficient ABH doesn't depend on T, then our problem is densely controllable from this space to L2. So this is very important introduction of definition, which allowed us to speak about the densely controllable problem. Here you can see the list of references. This is our references, Dmitry Lashin's and our. You can see it here. Here, you can see the mentioned and non-mentioned books concerning the problem of final observation or the observation or for the brief time, the briefest time, but not looks like our. And here you can see, of course, two famous books written by Ladyzhinskaya, Salonikov, Uraltseva, and by Ladyzhinskaya. We thank her for this wonderful, wonderful books, very precise and very beautiful, with very beautiful mathematics. And this is our publications, and this year, just now, we published these new results in this journal. Okay, thank you very much for your attention. Here you can see us.
Thank you.
This greenhouse. This is the largest one nearby Lipetsk in Donkov. And so you can see some new pictures. So thank you for your attention.
Thank you. Please, questions, remarks?
Maybe one remark my co-author say, but
yes, if it is possible, I am glad to say something.
Alexei, it's better to answer questions. I have a question. I understand that Sobolev scale and LP is a good scales for partial differential equations, but if a cucumber will be grilled at one moment and frozen at another, it will not very good. What's about your solution in Chebyshev in the C matrix?
I don't understand. Repeat.
Don't once. Understand too. What is Chebyshev matrix here?
Chebyshev, it's uniform.
Where
matrix.
Is it?
Uniform matrix, maximum of.
Oh, of course. Some results, as the positivity principle give us the possibility to obtain some results in such metric too, of course, but these spaces are not very suitable to study the extremal problems. Because
for our functional,
yes, because for our functional, it may be unbounded for such types of solutions.
Thank you. More questions? No. Thanks once more.
Okay.
And we have 1 minute break for change of speaker.